Hello everyone, this is Introduction to Electronics, that is EC251. So today we will start about negative feedback. This is chapter 18 of your textbook Oersted. So from your textbook only I am telling about this. Now first is feedback concept. So feedback is generally one type of operation where suppose this is one block diagram of the feedback is given. Now this is the main circuit. So we have one particular input, suppose this is Vi, that is the input voltage, and we will get some output, that is Vo, output voltage, and we have a particular gain, suppose the gain is A. That means our output voltage is A times of input voltage. Now if output voltage is fed back to the input side, that is called feedback system. For example, it is given to input system, but what we do generally, we don't directly feed it back, we give it to some particular multiplier, suppose it is beta. So beta times of output voltage is feedback to the input. This is the general feedback concept. Now we have these six main important point about the feedback, that is higher input impedance. Let me little bit increase the font size. Okay. Now it is visible well. So higher input impedance, number one. Number two is better stabilized voltage gain. This is number two. Number three is improved frequency response. Number four is lower output impedance. Number five is reduced noise. And number six is more linear operation. Okay. So this is the main points of feedback. Now this is simple block diagram of feedback amplifier. So this is input signal or Vi. It is going to the summing point of input and the feedback. Then it is going to the amplifier and we are having the output, and some portion of output, that is beta times of the output, is feedback to the input side. Now we have four type of feedback connection. These four type are voltage series feedback, voltage shunt feedback, current series feedback and current shunt feedback. This is the four type. So we can see series shunt and voltage current. So for voltage it is series and shunt, and for current it is series and shunt. This is the four type of feedback. Now we will see the diagram of each type. So there are total these four types, so we'll do one by one. Now first one is voltage series feedback. So let us start with this one, voltage series feedback. This is voltage series. Now how to recognize this as voltage series? We can see that this is the input portion and this is the output portion. Now output portion from these two terminals, the feedback is taken, and we know that voltage is taken in parallel and current is taken in series. So it is taken at the parallel configuration, so we are taking voltage. If it is taken for a single wire, then it was current. So now we are taking voltage, so here it is a voltage feedback. Now this is output voltage VO. This is fed to this network, it is beta. So we are having beta times of output voltage VO is fed back to the input. Now in the input, these two is the input terminals, this one and this one, that is positive and negative, and it is given here. So it is given in series function, it is given in series type, so this is called voltage series. Now coming to second, it is voltage shunt. So you can see number B is voltage shunt. So we'll now look at this. Now again we can see this is the two point from where the output is taken to do the feedback, that means it is voltage. Now it is feedback in this fashion, that means in parallel, that means in shunt. Here it was feedback in series, voltage was taken. Here also voltage is taken, but feedback is given in shunt. So this is voltage shunt. Now we'll do the another two type, that is current series and current shunt. So the left one is current series and the right one is current shunt. Now this is the table. This is the comparison of table giving all the gain of all the types together. So it has given gain without feedback. What is the feedback and gain with feedback of all the four types. Now for voltage series, gain without feedback, it is VO by VI. Next, voltage shunt. Okay, let's do it. Voltage series only on the four types. We are not taking on the four types. For voltage series only we are taking. So for voltage series, gain without feedback is output voltage by input voltage, that is VO by VI. Feedback is VF by VO. This is the feedback. And gain with feedback, it is given VO by VI. Next, voltage shunt. For voltage shunt, gain without feedback is VO by II. Feedback is IF by VO and gain with feedback is VO by IS. The next term is current series. For current series, the gain without feedback is IO by VI. Feedback is VF by I0 and gain with feedback is IO by VS. Next, we are going to the current shunt. There is the last one. For current shunt, we are having gain without feedback is IO by II. Feedback is IF by I0 and gain with feedback is I0 by IS. Next, we will do the individual feedback. Let us start with voltage series feedback. Now we have already seen the diagram of voltage series feedback, that figure shows voltage series feedback connection with the pair of output voltage fed back in series with the input signal, resulting in an overall gain reduction, because the feedback portion is coming to the input and it is being subtracted, so the overall gain is reduced. If there is no feedback, the voltage gain of the amplifier stage is A equal to V0 by Vs. Let us once again draw the Thank you. this is voltage series feedback. Now voltage series feedback connection with a part of the output voltage feedback in series with the input signal, resulting in an overall gain reduction. If there is no feedback, that is Vf equal to 0, that means this portion is not available. If if this portion is not available, so whatever the output we are getting, we directly get that if there is no feedback. So output voltage is Vo and input voltage is Vs, because as there is no feedback, Vi and Vs will be same, and if both are same, Vo by Vs equal to Vo by Vi. Now if a feedback signal Vf is connected in series with the input, then here we can see the original input is Vs, and with that feedback Vf is given, and if it is, these are subtracted, then Vi is feedback to the, there is a final voltage which is taken as the input of this system. So Vi equal to Vs minus Vf. Now since Vo equal to A into Vi, because here we can see A is equal to output by input, that is the, this system gain is output by input, output is Vo and input is Vi to this particular system. So A is equal to Vo by Vi. So here Vo equal to A Vi, and whatever Vi we are getting, that is equal to Vs minus Vf. So A into Vs minus Vf, so it is AVs minus AVF, and we know what is AVF, that is feedback voltage. Feedback voltage is beta times of output voltage, so that is AVs minus A of, in place of Vf, we are writing beta times Vo. So from this we can take this one. That is, okay, just let's write this one. Vo equal to, finally we are having AVS minus A into beta VO. Okay, so if we take this to the left hand side, so it will be VO minus, it will be plus A beta VO equal to AVS. Now if you take common VO, so it will be, if you take common, it will be 1 plus A beta equal to AVS. So now if we take, okay, this is only given Vo into 1 plus beta, that is equal to AVS. So we got the format which is given in the textbook. Now so overall gain with feedback is, overall gain is output voltage by the source voltage. So Vo by Vs, so Vo we can have Vo equal to AVs divided by 1 plus A beta. Now Vo by Vs, that is the source voltage, so if we do Vs, so Vs will be cut, up and down Vs will be cut. So that is A by 1 plus beta times A. So that is given here as the gain of the feedback is A by 1 plus beta times A. 1 plus A is beta. Same thing is given. Next is voltage shunt feedback. So for voltage shunt feedback also, let's refer to the original diagram. So the first change is the input, which is a current. This is IS and let's redraw the total diagram, it will be better. So this is IS, the input current source. This is the system. A equal to Vu by II. The current flowing, that is II, and we are having the output resistance as RL. This is Vo. This is voltage shunt feedback. So AF is the weak feedback gain. So it is given by output voltage, that is Vo, by input source current, that is IS. Now we can see that output voltage, that is A times II. II is the input current which is just entered into the system. So A times II, that is the output voltage, because II is the input current just entered into the system. A is the gain. So A into II is the Vo, and IS, we can see that is II plus II, because this is the source current it is going one at this side and one is one at this side. So IS is the total voltage, sorry, total current source. This total current source is dividing into two parts. One is going to the system as II, one is going as the feedback current, that is IF. And that's why it is given IS is the summation of these two current, II plus IF. So AII plus II plus, in place of IF, we can write this feedback current is actually beta times of output voltage. So we can replace it by beta of VO. And VO again, we can replace it by A into II. A into II, A is the gain, I is the input current. So A into II is VO. So this we can replace. So this is the final expression we are having. So this II and II you can take common. So here is 1 and here is beta I. This II will be cancelled with this II. So like that we can write A into II divided by II common 1 plus beta A. Now this II and this II is cancelled out. So finally it is A by 1 plus beta A. This is the voltage shunt feedback. Now you are taking to the input impedance with feedback for voltage series feedback. So we know that input current, that II equal to VI by ZI, where ZI is the impedance, and VI we can write VS minus VF. ZI is at the bottom always, and for the upper portion VS minus VF, in place of VF we can write beta VO, that is beta time VO. Here it is given, and for the place of VO we can also write A into VI, so that is given here. So next slide we can see II ZI equal to VS minus beta AVI. So VS equal to II ZI plus beta AVI equal to II ZI plus beta A II ZI. So finally from this we can get the expression ZIF equal to VS by II equal to ZI plus beta I into ZI, or we can write ZI into 1 plus beta I. This is the input impedance with feedback. The input impedance with series feedback is seen to be the value of the input impedance without feedback multiplied by the factor 1 plus beta A, and applies to both voltage series and current series configuration. This is the voltage series feedback connection is given. Now this is not a black box. Now inside is also given, and this is the input, that is RIF, and output is ROF. This is taken as feedback given to this beta. This is the beta is the feedback coefficient. It is feedback to the input. So this is voltage series feedback connection. So in today's lecture, up to this, we have seen that there are four types of feedback, mainly negative feedback connection. There are four types. That is voltage series, voltage shunt, current series, current shunt, and individually they are block diagram and equations we have seen. Thank you.